Hello students, today's lecture is on types of paper. The first type of paper that we are discussing is newsprint. And this is a mechanical printing paper, and as the name suggests, this particular newsprint paper is generally used for printing newspapers and also similar works. And a rotary letter press or an offset or an gravure can be used to print on these papers. And newsprint paper is generally the cheapest paper that we have of all the papers. The next type of papers is coated papers. Generally, coated papers are broadly called as art papers, and the best art paper generally has a coating of china clay or other minerals to each side after the body of the paper has been made. So different grades of coated paper are distinguished not only by the coating material and the amount of calendaring to which it is subjected to in the finishing process. And we also have writing papers, the normal writing papers that we use, which is suitable for writing with pen or inks, and those kind of papers are generally called as writing papers. And writing papers are generally made very carefully, and these are more expensive than printing papers. Bonds are another type of papers, which are generally papers of high strength and durability, and which are used for government bonds, stock certificates and legal papers. Today bond paper has a variety of uses, perhaps the most common of which is for writing paper. The next type of paper is gloss coated paper. These papers are generally used for flyers or brochures as it has high shine. And matte coated papers are opposite to gloss, and it is coated with matte finish to produce a paper that isn't shiny and it prevents glare. So this type of paper is also perfect for reports, flyers and leaflets. Recycled papers are made of reused paper products. Recycled paper is perfect for those who are trying to reduce their environmental impact, and it can be used mostly for documents including reports, memo paper and forms. We also have a type of paper called silk coated paper. This paper is different from gloss and matte because it has a silky smooth coating which leaves it smooth to touch but without the shine of a gloss paper. Uncoated papers are another type of papers which we generally find in office printers, and uncoated papers has no coating, which is very much suitable for ink receptivity and absorbency. As it is uncoated, it has the advantage of being used by both printer and pen, ideal for forms, letterheads and memo paper. Watermarked papers are also available in the market. So this high quality watermarked papers gives a feeling of luxury to the people who are using it. So till now we have been discussing the different types of paper based on the quality of the paper that we have. And when you're talking about types of paper, we also can have different types of paper based on the sizes of the paper. And sizes are generally mentioned as A0, A1, A2, A3, A4 or even A10. An A0 paper has a width of around 33.1 inches and the height would be 46.8 inches. If it comes to A1, it is 23.4 inches in width and 33.1 inches in height. So as you can see, as the number in the size increases, A0 is bigger, A1 is a bit smaller, and the normal A3 or A4 that we have, A3 has a 11.7 inch width and 16.5 inch height, and A4 has 8.3 inch width and 11.7 inch height. So you have to decide the paper based on the size and the type and the thickness in the final stage. So when you're talking about thickness, the weight value of the paper is measured in GSM, which is grams per square meter. So the higher the GSM, the better quality and the feel of the paper. The newspapers that we buy at home has a GSM of about 35 to 55. As you know, you would have seen that Tamil newspapers generally will be of a much lesser quality. The quality of the paper would be much lesser than the English newspapers. So there would be the range of GSM would be between 35 to 55 for most of the newspapers. And when you're talking about magazines inner pages, it would be somewhere around 90 GSM, and a good quality promotional poster generally has a GSM of about 130 to 250 GSM. And a magazine cover, as you would have witnessed, that the magazine inside pages will be much lighter and the outside cover of the magazine will be much thicker in a glossy sheet generally. So those kind of magazine covers will have a GSM of about 180 to 250, and mostly the good quality business cards where the GSM will be about 350. Okay, so with this we come to the end of this lecture. Thank you very much.